Hello everybody, this is Reid. Welcome to another Legacy video for ChannelFireball.com. What you see before you is the latest step in my brewing. I started with a variety of Soul Tie colored decks and have now moved on to this, you know, unwieldy four-color monstrosity in front of you, but I think it might just be crazy enough to work. This deck is mostly, you can consider it a blue-green deck, splashing black and splashing white. I only have two lands that produce white mana for three copies of Stoneforge Mystic in the main deck, and note that all eight of my mana creatures can produce white mana. And I'm also not very heavily invested into black mana. I've eschewed cards like Hymn to Turok, Liliana of the Veil, Thoughtseize. Just playing three Abrupt Decays, which I think is a really valuable card in a field of Counterbalance, and Chalice of the Void as well. And two copies of Leovold, Emissary of Trest, which is, I think, one of the most exciting new cards and a card that I'm really looking to play with. Now, this is a fairly simple strategy of just maximizing the chance of playing a turn one mana guy. Both Noble Hierarch and Deathrite Shaman are excellent cards. I prefer starting the game with one of them to even starting with a card like Delver of Secrets. And then maximize the chance of playing one of the super powerful three-drop creatures on turn two. True Name Nemesis, we know, is just one of the absolute best creatures ever printed in Magic. And Leovold is a new card that I think has a lot of great strengths, is applicable both against grindy decks and combo decks. And even stuff like lands, it has a lot more applications than you might think at first glance. Also playing with Jace the Mind Sculptor, which is great to accelerate out. And Stoneforge Mystic gives you staying power and the ability to turn even your unexciting creatures into really potent threats. Now, the other great thing about this creature configuration is that most of my potent creatures are blue, which gives me the ability to play Force of Will in my main deck without much effort. Now, this is not going to be the strongest deck in the world against opposing combo decks, since I don't have a lot of spell pierces and probably not quite as fast a clock as the Delver decks. However, I do have Force of Will and Daze, and I'm hoping that Leovold, Emissary of Trest, and some cards off the sideboard can pull their weight and give me a little bit of extra edge in combo matchups. But, you know, the main reason to play this deck is just exploiting a lot of the fair deck's vulnerability to a card like True Name Nemesis. So, that's the deck. That's what I'm trying out for today. And without further ado, let's join the league. My sideboard has a few more black and white cards, whereas the main deck is mostly blue and green. I can survive with, you know, basic forest and island, whereas I'm not playing basic plains or basic swamp. But off the sideboard, white gives me Swords to Plowshares, which is a creature removal spell that also represents an answer to something like Merit Lage, a card that the Soul Tie colors have a lot of trouble beating. And then black gives me Painful Truth, super strong card in any kind of grindy matchup, and Dread of Night to combat the rising popularity of Death and Taxes. Other than that, just, you know, a couple extra counter spells, as you'll expect for any blue deck that wants to compete against combo. And one nice thing about this deck that I'm playing, as opposed to various other versions of Soul Tie, is I can afford to play Rest in Peace, since Deathrite Shaman is the only card that utilizes my own graveyard. I'm not playing Tarmogoyf or Snapcaster Mage or Knight of the Reliquary, anything like that. Meddling Mage also should be a potent card against both combo, and I think I'll bring it in against Miracles to try to name Terminus, usually. So we'll see how this works out. Perfect. I don't have a name for this deck yet. I guess you could call it Dark Bant or something like that, since it's most directly an evolution of the Bant, you know, New Horizons type decks of old Legacy. Perfect. So this is just what the deck's meant to do. Turn one creature, turn two either True Name Nemesis or Leovold, depending on what the situation calls for. I just have to think about which creature and which land I want to play on the first turn of the game. I guess probably Noble Hierarch makes more sense. Just drop Clyla, Noble Hierarch. Noble Hierarch, definitely an underutilized card in Legacy. It really hasn't gotten a lot of love since Deathrite Shaman was printed. I mean, Deathrite Shaman is better, but Noble Hierarch's still great and is a perhaps a better fit for the Bant color strategies where the mana is actually perfect. And of course, you can build a deck like mine that plays both. Okay, so my opponent strips away the true named nemesis, which makes a lot of sense if he or she's playing something like Abzan. Doesn't have a lot of answers to true name. But turn two, Leovold is just what the doctor ordered, and I think the worst case scenario is that my opponent just spends a removal spell and I get a good clean 2-for-1. Ah, Esper. Esper Deathblade, which somewhat of a mirror match, though my deck is more heavily centered on green, whereas the Esper Deathblade is usually more centered on black and white, with green just being a splash. True Name Nemesis is a very excellent draw here. I think the plan should probably just be to attack for 4 with Leovold and then play True Name and Deathrite Shaman. I could get Supreme Verdicted. That is a little bit of a concern against Esper Deathblade, but I think not quite a big enough concern to make me play around it. I guess I could have the option to not add the Deathrite Shaman to the board, since I guess if True Name resolves, I'm probably only losing to a board sweeper. Okay, so Misty Rainforest, True Name, and then just pass if it resolves. If it gets Force of Will, then of course I can play a Deathrite. This also has the side benefit of saving Misty Rainforest for a Ponder next turn. Please, no Supreme Verdict. Okay, that's fine. Never seen this picture of Snapcaster Mage before. It's pretty cool. Note Leovold triggers off of you being targeted, which makes it particularly excellent against Thoughtseize and Cabal Therapy. I guess I rushed through that a little bit. I drew into Brainstorm off the Leovold trigger. I could have casted a response if I had wanted to, which, no, I don't think it would have even been necessary anyway. So here I could attack with both, offering to trade Leovold against both of my opponent's creatures, or I could just attack with True Name for 4 damage. I'm probably fine trading both creatures if that's what my opponent wants to do. Before anything else, why don't I cast Ponder? Wow, those are some nice ones. Well, sure. I think it's effectively forcing a trade here. My opponent can't very well take 6. Yep, that's fine. Trade off, and then second main phase, I will try to cast this Jace. All right. Well, that was a great showing for a first game with a new brew. Hopefully, I can have draws like that for the duration of this video. Now, what to bring in against Esper Deathbleed. Sometimes they have Lingering Souls, but I'm not going to jump to the Dread of Knights just yet. Meddling Mage, I don't think so. It's a little bit too diverse of a strategy to try to target one particular card. Painful Truths is a slam dunk, though. Submerge, we'll wait and see. Sometimes they can play the game without fetching out a green source of mana. Spell Piercer, Flusterstorm could be options. And Swords to Plashers seem like pretty good options as well. Take out a turn one Deathrite Shaman or a Stoneforge Mystic or something like that. Days on the Draw is certainly a bit less exciting. And I could also trim some of my mana guys if I don't want to be particularly vulnerable to a board sweeper. I kind of like Force of Will since Jace is powerful in and against both of these decks, and winning a battle over Jace can be pretty important. Yeah, I guess I could just cut the Dazes and call it a day. Flusterstorm, Spell Pierce, they're fine options. I think I'll run this. Well, one mana source hand. I can't keep this without a Ponder or a mana guy. It's a bit better. That makes it very good. So I actually kind of like just Wastelanding here. Do it in my opponent's upkeep is technically the best. Probably make the same play again, why not? And now I can play Noble Hierarch. Just deciding whether or not I want to crack the Misty Rainforest. I could get a Tropical Island, but no, I think Savannah Noble Hierarch's my best bet. Sure. So I finally ran my opponent out of lands here. I'm going to grab Underground Sea and play Leovold. Green, blue, black. Definitely don't want to cast the Deathrite into the Engineered Explosives. Alright, let's come in for four. Second main phase, I guess I can brainstorm. I think I want to bury the Deathrite. Well, I could bury the Deathrite in Misty Rainforest and then ponder with the possible intent of shuffling, or I could put Deathrite and Swords to Plowshares on top, play the Misty Rainforest. Yeah, I like this plan. So I'll put Deathrite and then Swords to Plowshares on the top of my library, play Misty Rainforest, pass the turn. If my opponent casts a creature, I have the option to draw the swords. If my opponent misses another land drop, then no problem, I can shuffle it away. So yeah, I'm gonna shuffle in response. Tropical Island. Now draw off the Leovold. And now let the Inquisition resolve. Could brainstorm. Yeah, I guess I'll brainstorm. It's not worth it. I'll just let it resolve. Okay. Untap and brainstorm. If I ever get to put that Jace into play, it's going to be over. It looks like my opponent's just had enough, doesn't want to play a mana screwed game. Well, all right. That's a good first showing for, we'll call it Dark Bant.